Hello, and welcome to this teaching point. We are going to talk a little bit about fluidics today because fluidics is an important concept in flow cytometry. And additionally, it's part of the content outlined from the certification cytometry exam. And specifically in the fluidics section, they discuss or ask for you to discuss the questions about hydrodynamic focusing and the properties of sheath fluid, and how do you generate differential pressure. So let's jump right in. Sheath fluid is the liquid that the sample is injected into, and this moves the sample through the flow cell. We require laminar flow to ensure that there's little or no mixing between the sample and the sheath fluid, and we'll talk about that in just a second. A couple of common sheath fluids include water, just distilled water. Recommend adding a surfactant, something like 0.1% 2-phenoxyl ethanol. This helps reduce the surface tension, and it is good for improving flow of the sample. Also found for high throughput systems, having just pure water with the surfactant is better because you don't see a lot of crystallization, which can happen, especially if the HTS is not used on a regular basis. Of course, this is not for sorting. Now, most people typically use a PBS, a phosphate buffered saline, and this can either include a surfactant or not, and that depends on the vendor that you buy it from or if you make it yourself. And then it may or may not have preservatives. Oftentimes they use azide. Sodium azide is a great preservative, but of course you have to take care when you're disposing of it. For sorting, what I like to use is HBS or heaps buffered saline. The reason for this is because HBS is good for high pressure sorting applications and because it buffers better than PBS at high temperature. Now, we make this ourselves, and so whenever you're making your own sheath, I strongly encourage you to check both the pH and the salinity. Here's just a typical salinity meter that you can buy from any vendor for about $20. Now, I mentioned that we need to have laminar flow. Laminar flow is the idea of smooth flow, that each layer moves smoothly with little or no mixing. So here we have the walls of our flow cell, and here's the direction of flow. Now, you can see we're illustrating that these different layers are moving in uniform. Because of friction on the side, we start to get this slow down at the edges, so ultimately we get kind of this L-shaped curve of speed. Now, this is turbulent flow, like we see at the Niagara Falls. That's not what we want. That will cause all sorts of problems. Once we've established our laminar flow, we are going to hydrodynamically focus our samples because we're going to inject our samples into the center of the stream at a slightly different pressure. That will allow the sample to stay within the laminar flow and keep it contained, and allow the cells to spread off along the velocity axis. As long as the two liquids differ in velocity or density, they won't mix and they form a stable, two-layer stable flow system. This is why we can use water and not PBS for our sheath fluid. Now, here is a typical flow cell. We have our sample being injected here. Our sheath fluid is running in this direction in red. And as the sample is injected, you'll see it's coming in as a blob. With hydrodynamic focusing, we force the cells along the velocity axis to pass single file by the laser intercept. Now, there's a couple of ways we can generate this. The most common is a differential pressure system. Here we have our sheath fluid. Here we have an air compressor. You'll see that we have two different valves that we're going to adjust. The first one sets the sheath fluid, and we see the sheath fluid running here into our flow cell. When we add our sample to this tube, we've got to make sure that we have a good seal here. We have this valve here, and now it's going to let us pressurize this tube, and our cells are going to run through our flow cell contained in the center of the stream. This is one of the most common methods for generating, moving cells through our fluidics pathway, but importantly, its control is not absolute. To get better, more absolute control, we use things like volumetric injection-based systems. And in this case, the sheath fluid is set by either a gas or syringe. Here we're showing it's being sent by a pump. The sheath fluid is again pressurized, establishing our laminar flow. We have our sample, which does not have to be in a nice tight seal like with our differential pressure system. The sample is pulled into here, into the syringe. The syringe then injects it into the center of the sheath. Differential pressure is established because of the force of the pump, and the pump control is absolute. So we have much better counting and know the number of events that go through in a volumetric system.